Good morning and welcome to CFBNJ's Wellness Wednesday Live. My name is Tiffany Stribling. I'm a senior nutrition educator here at the Food Bank, working with the SNAP Ed program. Today we're going to make a no-bake cheesecake recipe with strawberries and blueberries. And we're highlighting blueberries a little bit, so we'll talk a little bit about that as we go through the recipe. For the ingredients today, we will need some graham crackers. I chose the low-fat version of the graham crackers. We have some fresh strawberries, fresh blueberries, honey, cinnamon, and ricotta cheese. Now, when I was going through the recipe, I read like the reviews a little bit, and I saw that somebody mentioned that they would have added vanilla extract to it, so we're also going to add vanilla extract. Also, for our ricotta cheese, we went with the low-fat option as opposed to non-fat. I just like the way the low-fat holds better. The non-fat was a little watery. So those are the ingredients that we're going to use. We also have the zest of one lemon included as well. So I have everything kind of measured out already, so we're just going to add everything into our mixing bowl. We have our ricotta cheese already inside. We're going to add our cinnamon, about a teaspoon. We're going to add the zest of one lemon. And keep in mind, once you zest the lemon, if you need it for something else, you can still use it. You don't have to throw the lemon away just because the zest is now missing. We're going to add our honey. Now, do you ladies enjoy cheesecake?
I love cheesecake. I feel like you can never go wrong with it. Especially like this version, because I feel like it's like a guiltless
right.
option.
Yeah, I agree. I don't usually do fruit, but this was a nice switch up.
It's so great.
Right.
You can never go wrong. Especially because berries are in season.
They're
so
in season,
they taste the best now. Which I always love to buy stuff.
Right. So we're gonna mix this up. We just wanna make sure everything's incorporated. Now this is a good recipe if you have like children or little brothers, sisters, nieces, nephews in the house, something that they can kind of get involved with, especially when it comes to like smashing up the graham crackers. That's something they can do. And for that you just put the graham crackers in like a Ziploc bag. If you have a rolling pin or a mallet or something, you can just kind of let them go to town on those to mash them up. And then I'm sure they'll also enjoy the layering portion. So most of this recipe is already done now. That was the hardest part, putting the ingredients together and mixing them. So now we can get into the building portion. Dana, if you want to come and help me a little bit.
Yeah.
So you can kind of get creative with this. Build it how you want. Like I said, if you have children, this will be something that they enjoy. So you just want to fill the bottom of the cup with the graham crackers. That's going to be like our crust if you were doing like a real cheesecake. And then you're going to go in with your filling. And it has a nice red, white, and blue kind of color scheme going on. So this would be a nice like Memorial Day or 4th of July type recipe. I'm just going to add the filling in. And you just want to kind of level it out. And then you can add your fruits. Now, you can do one, either strawberries or blueberries. You can do both. It's really no wrong way to do it. You can make it pretty. You can just kind of throw them in there. Now, some of the benefits that we're getting from adding blueberries, they're very high in antioxidants. They help with digestion. They add a little bit of fiber to your diet. The same thing with the strawberries. They help with regulating blood pressure and things like that. So you just want to keep that in mind because of both.
Oh.
And then you can also go in and top it with more of the graham cracker just for like some added texture. Now we're using small cups. If you use a bigger cup and you want to add more layers, there's no wrong way to do it. Like I said, this is going to be your finished product. No big cheesecake with strawberries and blueberries.
Okay, to go along with that, I thought that we would make a sparkling blueberry mocktail if you want something different than just water during the summer, this is really refreshing. What you'll need is, of course, blueberries. They're in season, they're delicious. The juice of one lemon, which you can either squeeze it fresh, or if you buy the bottle of lemon, it's gonna be about 2 to 3 tablespoons in each lemon. So that's what we did there. I pre-measured out some lemon juice. And then about 1 ounce or about 2 tablespoons of any sweetener of your choice. You can do simple syrup if that's what you have at home, agave. Today we're using honey. And then we're also gonna add some rosemary. Now this is what rosemary looks like on the sprig. And to actually get the rosemary off, I'll show you. You can see how all of them are going up. So if you take this and pull it down, you should be able to get your leaves out. So you're gonna unleaf the rosemary and put it in your cup on the bottom, about 2 of them. You're gonna take a handful of blueberries, put that in. You put your lemon juice at the bottom. And lastly, your honey. And then you're gonna muddle. So muddling really brings out the aromatics of the rosemary and also like the oils in the rosemary, so you can really taste it. And then you're just gonna, you don't even have to have a muddle for this. Today I'm just using the back of a spoon. So in there, make sure that you get all of it combined, mix it around. An aromatic. So, Juliana, what do you think you're going to be doing this summer?
Well, I'm going on vacation, so I'm excited about that.
Where are you going?
I'm going to Nashville.
That's so fun.
Yeah. What about you?
I mean, I just this past weekend went down the shore, which was so fun. But other than that, I've been here since me and Juliana are interns, so a lot of our time has been doing that, and we love it. So now that we have that pretty much muddled, take this out, and in a separate cup with ice, what we're gonna do is we're gonna strain so that we're not drinking rosemary sprigs. So you can take any cup, put it over the top, and just strain the juice.
Were you a bartender in your past life?
No. I mean, I don't know. Who knows? I'm living out my Blue Network dream right now, so that looks like about enough.
I love the color.
Yeah, no, it's beautiful. Oh my god. And that's all the color comes from the antioxidants, so in a blueberry or like kale or any dark leafy greens, that's what it comes from. And to top it off, we're gonna add some seltzer water. This is just plain seltzer water. You can do like a fancy flavored one if you think that'll be a good tasting. Like you can do like maybe an orange seltzer water, a lemon seltzer water, or anything your heart desires. It's really adaptable. Add that in. Top it off for a little garnish with a sprig of rosemary. And that's the strawberry blueberry mocktail recipe. Yeah, I love that.
It looks so good. And then I'm Juliana, I have our next drink. So I'm gonna be making a version of a blueberry lemonade. So we're again highlighting blueberries. So for this, it's really easy, really simple. We just are using 1/3 cup of blueberries. We're using the juice of about 2 lemons. A tablespoon of honey, some ice, some water, and then I just got some mint to top it off. You can do that if you'd like. So the first thing I did was took 1/3 cup of blueberries and I put them in the bottom of this cup and then just mashed them up, kind of like Dana was doing before. I did that already and I just used this. So there's a lot of different options for how you can go about mashing them. This was the easiest. If you'd like a smoother texture, you can use a blender. And then you can also strain it as Dana did before, or to use a strainer just to not have the pulp. But you can leave it. That's what I'm going to do. So I think it tastes good like that. So then the next thing you're going to add is the honey. So it's about 1 tablespoon. I measured enough for both of these, so I'm just going to put about half. So refreshing.
And you, like, know what's going into it when you're doing this, which I feel like it's so great.
Right.
And especially because you're using honey, it's better than, like, refined white sugar.
Exactly. And you could always taste it at the end and see if you want to add more honey. I just added a tablespoon just for at the beginning. And then this is about the juice of 4 lemons, so I'm going to use half in each one. And the next thing I'm going to add is some ice to this. You can add as much ice as you'd like. That might smother my head. Okay. So then you're going to just add some water.
That's pretty.
And just mix it. And then the last thing you're going to add is the mint garnish. And then at the end, if you need some more lemon or honey, you can always just add that in. But yeah, this is pretty much the finished product.
Nice. Love that. Can I have a question? Summer's Day.
Yes. We hope you give each of these recipes a try. They're great for the summer. The no-bake cheesecake saves you with heat in the house, so I guess turn the oven on. And of course, lemonade and any kind of mocktail or unmocktail is also a great option.